Good morning and happy Easter. Welcome to the Eucharistic liturgy of the resurrection of the Lord. Please turn off or silence your cell phones at this time. As today's collection is taken up by the ushers, we have a special basket for all the children. Please invite them to come forward. Please stand up for the gathering hymn as we begin our celebration.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice, for we have died with the Lord, and we are risen with him. So we sing together the hymn number 540 in the blue hymnal. Jesus Christ is risen today. 540.
Let us begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
We're just waking up, right? We're waking up. Today, instead of having this moment of the penitential rite, we're going to renew our baptismal promises, or we're sprinkling with water. Let us get together to praise God and to give him glory.
Thank you.
was vengeance. Let us pray. O God, who in this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us a path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, raise up in the light of life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on the tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Please remain seated as we listen to the Easter sequence.
Is life indeed, victorious King in heaven.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciples whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This is going to be my second year here in this parish. I have 2 years of being a priest. This is what I have seen in our parish. I have seen adults, seniors, being alone in their homes, not having anybody, widows and widowers, living in homes by themselves, maybe not having any family members anymore, right? And I have seen the most happy seniors I have ever seen under those circumstances. And I have seen the most miserable seniors living in that same circumstances. I also have the chance to get to know couples that are going through struggles, thinking on a probably divorce, fighting to each other every single day, and they are the most miserable people on this earth. I also know couples that fight, that don't get along pretty well, but they keep trying and trying, and they are the most happy people on this earth. I have seen a guy working in a store, making a little money, probably 250, 300 pounds, and he's the most miserable man on this earth. And I know a guy who makes a little bit of money, who has the same weight, and he's the most happy person on this earth. I have seen people that went through abuse, through a horrible mother and father, and they are the most happy people on this earth, or the most miserable people on this earth. I can go so far as to say, I know priests that they are the most miserable people on this earth, or the most happy people on this earth. You know what is the difference? Christ, the encounter with Jesus. And that's beyond any circumstances that are happening around us. The life of Christ is what changes our hearts and our lives. And it can whatever can happen to us. But if we have encountered Christ and the risen one, Christ who is alive, our lives will be so much different. I have seen teenagers in this parish bored to death, doing nothing than playing games, because they don't have anything better to do. And I have seen teenagers full of life, involving their communities. I just took a couple of them to Europe, full of life, because they have encountered Christ. That's what changes everything. That's what changes everything. I have seen people sick with cancer, terminal illness, and they are the most happy people or the most miserable. And we can be here in this church, sitting together, and yet we have a different experience of Christ. My hope today, as we celebrate the resurrection of Christ, is that you will be one of those that experience life, that will not stay on the tomb. How horrible it is when I get to know Christians that stay on the tomb. Nothing happens in their life. Hopefully today the miracle of that stone rolling, opening the tomb for you will happen. That you will come back to life. And it's not because your reality will change. Hopefully one day I will have that magic of changing people's life, right? People will come to me and say, Father, I'm going through this and I'm going through this. One day I will have the power to say, let's change it, and everything will be changed. But in the meantime, it all depends on us. I have seen people losing a loved one that were together for years, and they are gone. They are not here anymore. They celebrated Easter together last year, and today there is an empty space next to them. And they are the most happy people on this earth, or the most miserable. Our faith on the resurrected one is what changes our reality. And if you haven't experiencing yet, ask for that miracle to happen. Pray to God. Sometimes we think that God likes playing with us, hide and seek. You look for me, I hide. God wants to be found. We just need to ask. Let me experience the resurrection in my life. I don't have anything better to do. Let me experience that life, and Christ will give it to you. I have seen young adults in our community begging for love from someone that don't even care about them. I have seen young adults begging for love, getting into drugs and alcohol, and going to parties every night, begging for love. And I have seen young adults full of love, knowing that God has loved them to the point of the cross, and they don't need anything else to be happy. Not drugs, not alcohol, nothing. They already have everything they need. I have seen it. I have experienced it. Like the apostles in the first reading, I have seen it. I have seen the power of the resurrection. A couple of years ago, I was looking for a bell. The moment that I enjoy the most during Easter and the celebration is when I have to ring the bells. I don't know why. And people are so annoying by the bell. It's like, oh, he is so loud. But I love it. And this is why. I was looking for a bell, and I went to a flea market. And it was really hard to find the bell. I finally saw a bell, and I was like, yes. And so I went and I asked, how much is this one? It was kind of expensive. Bells are expensive, right? And the guy said, well, he gave me the price. And he said, why do you want a bell? It was the Easter Holy Saturday, the Easter Vigil. And I was like, if I say that I'm a priest, you know that I'm always afraid to say that I'm a priest. And so I said, well, we're going to ring it tonight. And he was like, tonight? Are you coming from a church? And I said, yes. And then he said, all right, I'll give it to you. I said, no, I can pay for it. He says, no, listen, this morning I was praying. My mom just passed away 2 weeks ago. And she insisted me in going to church, and I never listened. And today I was thinking, I might go to church. And then a priest arrived to hear. He was like, what's the chances of that? Right? I was like, cool. He started telling me his story. He comes from a very traumatic history. Right? His dad left. His mom just passed away. Oh, it was so many things. I ended up telling him, listen, tonight I'm going to ring the bell. And as I ring the bell, I will pray for you to come back to life. That was 2 years ago. And in every Easter vigil, I still ring that bell. Ready to be annoying. Think on something in which you need life, the life of the resurrected one, your relationship, your life in general, you being a father, not knowing what to do, you being a mother, not knowing what to do. Where do you need the resurrected, the power of the resurrection? And if you can close your eyes and let me ring that bell for you. May the Lord grant you life. May you not stay in the tomb. The Lord is risen. Alleluia, alleluia. Please stand. With a loud voice, let us profess our faith, the faith of the whole church. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered dead and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. On this holy day, when Jesus Christ rose from the dead and restored our life of grace, we turn to God our Father in prayer, asking for all of our needs.
For Pope Francis and all leaders of the Church, may the celebration of the resurrection of the Lord bring new life to their service to the people of God. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who believe in the resurrection, that through our sharing in the life of the risen Lord, this Easter may mark for us a new beginning in our life of faith. Let us pray to the Lord. For peace in our world, that the peace promised by the Lord will become a reality for all people, especially where there is war and violence. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those baptized or received into full communion with the Church, that they may continue to grow in faith and love of God, let us pray to the Lord. That the people of every nation may come to share the joy of this day, and that the good news of the death and resurrection of Christ may gladden the hearts of all. Let us pray to the Lord. For all whose lifelong vigil for the Lord has ended, and who now sleep in death, that they may live forever in Christ, who has destroyed the power of death and opened the gates of heaven to all. Let us pray to the Lord. For our personal petitions, for those who have asked for our prayers, for those whose names are written in our prayers request book, and for those who have recently died. Materna Loma Dolatina, Frank De Leon, Rodolfo T. Gonzalez, Sr. Let us pray to the Lord. And for the special intentions of this Mass, for the eternal repose of Juan Torres, Robert and Bessie Fuentes, and Henry Sanchez, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God, our Father, as we celebrate the resurrection of Christ, your Son, we ask you to strengthen us in faith, that we may proclaim the pardon and peace you have given us. We make this prayer through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the glory of the Church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your Church is wondrously reborn and nourished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is a true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exalting your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. May holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, Gustavo our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be merited to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. At this moment, we will have the distribution of Holy Communion, and knowing that we have a lot of guests, right? Everyone is welcome. If you're a non-Catholic and you want to receive a blessing, just cross your hands in front of your chest like this, and the minister is going to give you a blessing. You can remain seated if you prefer. If you're a Catholic, but for some reason you are not able to receive communion, you can do the same. Just cross your hands, the minister is going to give you a blessing. You can remain seated if you prefer. If you're Catholic and you're able to receive communion, there's two ways. One is in your hands. Just place your hands in front of the minister, The minister is going to place the body of Christ in your hands. Please consume the body of Christ in front of the minister. Don't take it to the pew. The other one is in your mouth. Just open your mouth, and the minister is going to place the body of Christ in your mouth. It's one or the other. If you put your hands and open your mouth, the minister will not know what to do. Again, everyone is welcome.
Our communion prayer song in the blue gather hymnal is number 524. 524, Alleluia, number one.
as Deacon finishes with the purification of the sacred vessels, since today is Easter, we don't have a second collection. During the Easter season, the Knights of Columbus are offering a family and faith video series called Into the Bridge. It will be offered every Wednesday in the Parish Hall from April 10th to May 8th. There is more information in the bulletin. Do we have any visitors today coming from another parish of another town? If you can please stand so that we can recognize you. Good, welcome. Over there in the back. Where are you coming from? From Del Rio, but it's on the way to McAllen. All right. From Laredo. Welcome to our community. From the Bali. Ubaldi. From Ubaldi. Welcome to our community, and we hope that whenever you're around, come and visit. This is a beautiful community. St. Luke is one of the best, if not the best. And those who are celebrating a birthday or an anniversary, if you can please stand. Birthdays or anniversaries. It's the two of you, it's your birthday. Happy birthday. Three of you, happy birthday. And let us stand our hands and let us pray for them, for their life. We give you thanks, Lord, for the gift of life, and we ask you to bless our brothers and sisters who are celebrating their birthday. Give them joy and all the graces they need to continue having a happy, joyful life. In your name we pray, amen. I don't have a name here. You have it in there. Robert and Clarissa. Yeah.
You call us by name and made us members of your people, the Church. Guide us to know our vocation in life and to respond by living your spirit of holiness. For your greater glory, for the service of your people, raise up dedicated and generous members who will serve their lives as women and men, religious, priests, deacons, married or single. Send your spirit to guide and strengthen us, so we may serve your people, following the example of your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we offer this prayer. Amen. Thank you very much for praying for vocation. Now please stand.
All right. Listen. You are going back to your reality, right? Nothing has changed. It was just an hour and 10 minutes. So you are going back to that reality. But you can be the most miserable person on this earth, or you can be the most happy person on this earth with that reality. What makes the difference is the encounter you have had with Christ. Let's take a few seconds in silence. And if you want and if you can, I have seen Christ change my life and has changed the life of many that are here. Ask him to change yours, to give you a new life, to strengthen you, to give you courage to go away from the things that you have to go away, to have the courage to say no to the things you have to say no, and yes to the things you have to say yes. And let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let's go in peace to announce the gospel of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Our final hymn of praise is number 520 in the Blue Gather Hymnal. 520, this is the feast of victory. We'll sing the first two verses.